There are 8 smaller cubes in that. If we consider this entire picture as a crystal lattice, consider this bigger cube as a crystal lattice. This small crystal lattice contains how many unit cells? 8 unit cells. That means this bigger cube contains 8 cubes, 8 smaller cubes. Now let us consider this point in this picture. This point indicates what? You know, this point is the corner point for 8 unit cells. Just have a look on that. This is corner of, see, this is first cube, second cube. So these two, this is a plane. To this plane, below 2 cubes, above 2 cubes. Adjacent, below 2 cubes, above 2 cubes. That means this is the corner atom sharing how many unit cells? Above 2, above 4, below 4. Total 8 unit cells. A corner atom shares how many unit cells? Yes, a corner atom shares how many unit cells? 8 unit cells total. That's why here in a simple cube, there are 8 corner atoms. But each corner atom shares how much? Only 1/8 part of atom. That's why effective number of atoms in a primitive cube equals, it is denoted by the symbol Z effective. So Z effective for a simple cube, how to calculate? There are 8 corners in a simple cube. Into each corner atom shares how much? Yes, sir. Each corner atom shares 1/8. That's why 8 into 1/8, 1. So in a primitive cube, effective number of atoms in a unit cell, 1. Have you got this? How it is 1? Why? Because there, in a cube, there are 8 corners, but corner atom is not a complete atom. Per unit cell, it is 1/8 part of atom. That's why 8 into 1/8, 1. So this is the effective number of atoms in simple cubic system.